Hey folks, Sirdar here, and in this episode of Dev with Sirdar, I'm going to introduce the Htmx JavaScript library. This is a small, fast, and convenient way to make HTML work with interactive features like WebSockets and Ajax. Now, if you want to build a site that has interactivity, you need JavaScript, and more often than not, you need a framework like Angular or React to handle all the details of how front-end components talk to the back-end and vice versa. But those are bulky frameworks, and they tend to hijack your workflow and your design decisions. HTMX works with HTML that's very plain and requires little more than adding a few tags here and there. So let's start with a super simple example of HTMX in action. I have here a web page that has two things on it, a button and a named div, which is currently empty. And every time I click this button, I want to get a randomly chosen fortune cookie delivered from an API endpoint displayed in the named div. Now for HTMX, all we need to do this is a few lines. So first at the top, we import the HTMX library, which is a mere 14K of minified JavaScript. And then we take our cookie button and we add a couple of pieces of custom tagging to it, each prefixed with HX to indicate that they're HTMX tags. HX trigger means when we interact with this element in this way, we will do something HTMX related. The default action is a click, which I've spelled out here explicitly, but it could be many other events, and we'll see a couple of examples of those later. HX post means the action to take is to make a post request to this API endpoint, cookie. HX target means the named element is going to receive the resulting data from the post. And HX swap means we're going to swap something on the page for the data that we've received. And in this case, it's going to be the inner HTML of the named ID, cookie. So I've set up a simple web app to serve this page and provide a response from the endpoint. So when I load and click the button, you can see we're getting the action triggered. We're getting a cookie delivered from this endpoint every time we click. And all of that with just a couple of simple declarations. See, one very nice thing about the HTMX approach is that many of the most common interactive use cases are either native to HTMX or are easy recipes that you can put together. For instance, let's take this old example of the infinite scroll display. And the way we do this is by having some element at the bottom of the elements that we're scrolling through tagged with HTMX. So in this case, it's a table, and we have the bottommost row with HTMX tags. The trigger action for HTMX here is revealed, meaning that our trigger runs whenever this item comes into view. And so when it comes into view, it fetches content using a GET request from some endpoint, and then we swap the results of that request with this element. Now here's the magic. What we're loading, which is constructed by this template, is another set of table rows. But the last row is another one of these fetch on reveal rows like the one we had originally, except this one requests the next set of rows using the page parameter in the URL. This requires us to have an endpoint that supports that behavior, but you get the idea. So when we run this, we can just scroll forever through this list of movies. And all of that we've done by just setting up an endpoint and adding a couple of HTMX declarations to this code. Here's one more example. This is another common pattern, a type to search field. We type in this input box and we send a request to the backend to retrieve data that matches the request, which is formatted as an HTML table, which we display. So all the code that we need for this on the HTMX side of things is right here in the input tag. We have a post endpoint and we have a target for the results like we saw before. But we now also have a more sophisticated trigger. We can trigger on either the key up or the changed events. And after a short delay, we then trigger the events on this specific tag. In this case, it's the input tag. And we can also have an indicator that is shown and then hidden while we're performing the fetching of data from the server. You notice that we can refer to the indicator by a class, meaning that everything that is tagged with this class would be shown and hidden. So we don't have to use just a single specific element. So when we run this and we type to search, we can see results coming up live. And again, all of this with just a few tags. So one of the beauties of HTMX is how you can write plain HTML, mark it up in a relatively unobtrusive way, and make it interactive at a fraction of the development cost of wiring this kind of thing up manually. Also, HTMX provides hooks for your own JS code. You are not limited to the functionality HTMX alone gives you, although there is a surprising amount of it. So it's worth looking through the examples and the official documentation to get an idea of what is possible above and beyond what you've seen here. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.